In Houston at NASA's Johnson Space Center, I'm Jason Mader, joined by Colonel Shane Kimbrough, a 1998 graduate of Georgia Tech. He got his master's degree in operations research. He will blast off from Kazakhstan, bound for the International Space Station, a mission that will last until the middle of February. How in the world do you get ready both physically and mentally?
Great question. Physically, we work out quite a bit here on Earth. We're going to have to work out every day in space to maintain our bone density and bone mass. So that's not something new for me. I've been kind of into working out my whole life. So that's a good thing. Emotionally, somewhat different. We as a family have been doing a lot together and talking about the separation. I have girls getting ready to go to college, so that's another big step in our family's life. So exciting things are happening, but all of them are kind of tearing us apart, so to speak.
What types of things will you be doing up in the ISS?
I'm going to get the good fortune to go outside and do a couple spacewalks. That'll be early on in our mission. We could do a lot of science and research, which is really the purpose of the International Space Station, is for us to get to look at things and experiments that scientists from all around the world have provided us the opportunity to look at in that unique environment of microgravity.
This isn't his first time in space. So you went in 2008, Space Shuttle Endeavour, two spacewalks then, but only 16 days. When people go on vacation, they're like, if I could ever get back, I want to make sure to do this or enjoy that more. How is it different going a second time, and are there things you're really looking forward to?
I'm certainly looking forward to doing several things when I'm there. Some of the things when I was there last time were not there that are there now. One being the cupola, which is a kind of a mini module it's all glass, it's 360 degrees, it looks at Earth all the time. So you can kind of just hang out in there, and my friends, my colleagues that have done it, just say it's kind of better than a spacewalk because you don't have to get all your spacesuit and everything on. You're just kind of there looking at planet Earth and taking some great pictures. So that'll be one thing I'm looking forward to.
Here's the question you always get asked. How do you explain what it's like to blast off into space? And how do you even explain what it's like to be up there?
That's a great one. I'm not sure I can perfectly answer it. When I was on the space shuttle, really it was an incredible experience to launch off the planet. It was a little slower initially than I expected, but a few seconds after I thought that in my head, it was like I got sucked back in my seat and knew I was going somewhere really, really fast. Not sure where I was going, but I was going somewhere fast. I was laughing the whole way because it's like being on a roller coaster, just, you know, pulling G's as you're going around a turn for 8 minutes straight. So it was pretty spectacular.
Where do you see the space program going? What will students today perhaps be doing if they are chosen to be astronauts someday?
We're on a great trajectory to send humans to places like Mars here in the next few decades, which is pretty crazy, but exciting too. Because as we do that and we develop, you know, the mission for that, there's so much that comes out of the technology that's going to be helpful here on Earth. We at NASA, that's really what we're about, is not just flying in space, it's about helping people on our planet.
There are six Americans that are going to be on board the International Space Station in 2016, and two of them are Georgia Tech graduates. 14 astronauts in Georgia Tech, you're one of them. Thanks for the time today, and Godspeed.
Thank you, thanks for the time.
Go Jackets.
Go Jackets.